One of the most important questions that is being asked about ChatGPT is data privacy, and they are continuing to improve the controls that we as the users have over data privacy, but it's still not where we need it to be unless you know how to navigate the privacy settings. So they've just made some improvements to user control of data privacy and chat history. You want to think about it like this. Your chat history shows up in the sidebar. If something shows up in the sidebar, that means that they can use it to train their model, which means that data could end up back into the data set, which means that that data might appear or be assimilated into answers to questions or prompts by other people. So anything that needs to be private, anything that's confidential, anything that's proprietary, you cannot have in the chat history. So how do you control that? Well, when you go to settings, they new have a new settings area here. Data controls, you'll see a new panel here. Chat history and training on and off. When you're going to do a private confidential chat, you need to come in here and you need to turn this off. Okay? If you do turn it off, that chat history will no longer be available in ChatGPT, and it won't be able to use the prior responses to help you with future responses. So chat history is really nice to have because it guides the additional information that's provided by GPT on that same thread. So if you have a topic, you want to have it in the chat history in the sidebar, and it will remember by topic what it is you're talking about and what the prompts are that came before. If you don't have chat history enabled, then it's not going to remember. You have to start with a new prompt sequence each time you ask a question. But let's go to some of the information that they've provided here in these data controls FAQ. We're going to go through this in future in detail, but today I just want to show you something that's really important, and it allows you to go ahead and keep chat history, but at the same time preclude OpenAI from using that chat history to train its model. So you get the benefit of chat history, you get the benefit of all the prompt history in a sequence, in a topic that gets preserved, but they're not going to use it to train their model. So when you go into this area, you're going to come down here to this section here, and it says, what if I want to keep my history on but disable model training? You're going to go and you're going to fill out this form. When you click on this link, it's going to take you to this form. User content opt-out request. This is the best thing that's happened to ChatGPT since it was launched. So you're going to come down here, you can read this form, but essentially it's going to allow you to opt out of the training using your data. And so you're going to be able to go through this form, get your account organization settings. Your email is what is associated with the ChatGPT Plus account. Your organizational information is what's used with your API. And you put your organization name in here. You're going to submit this form. You're going to pick the traffic lights, and boom, you get all the benefits of chat history without having to worry about data privacy. You're welcome. My name's Enrico. We'll see you next time.